Welcome to Queen Mary's High School virtual classes. I'm Mrs. Naushaba Sheikh, your geography teacher. Let's begin. Now students, observe the video very carefully. What do you see? The boy is playing in the water. Yes. Can you guess the title? Come on students. See, sometimes the water is coming very close to the boy. And sometimes it is very far away. Did you get the hint? Okay, let's see one more. Try to guess with the help of these hints. Now, look carefully on your screen. What do you see? There are two photographs. Are they same? Is the place same or is the place different? Yes, the place is same in photograph A as well as in photograph B. But there is some difference in the two photographs. Correct. In photograph A, the level of the water is very high. Whereas in photograph B, the level of the water is very low. In photograph A, the water is very close to the coast. Whereas in photograph B, the water is very far away from the coast. Students, now can you guess the chapter's name? Yes, you're right. The name of the chapter is Tides. Let us learn. Students, if you stay for some time near the coast area, you will observe that the water level rises sometimes and the water level drops sometimes. What is this natural event called? Yes, it is called as tides. All the coast on the earth's surface experience tide, except for few exceptions. There is high tide and low tide. This is a natural phenomena. We will try to understand about this natural event, tides. Students, you know that tides occur on daily basis as well as on regular basis. There is movement in the seawater, which is regular as well as on daily basis. The level of seawater changes after a specific period of time. And what is a specific period? It is 12 hours and 25 minutes. A cycle of high tide and low tide gets completed. You know, students, tide is directly related to the sun, the moon and the earth and the gravitational and centrifugal forces that interact between them. Students, you have learned about gravitational force. You know that gravitational force is pulling the object towards the earth surface. It's the reason that two objects get attracted because of the gravitational force and they never fall off from the earth's surface. You might be thinking, what is centrifugal force then? Let us understand this with the help of few activities. Take a small stone or a chalk piece on your notebook. Take water in a small container which has handle and then turn around with a force. Fill the mixer jar with water and switch on the mixer. Do this under the supervision of your parents. Observe a fan or a slingshot while they are moving. Take half a glass of water and slowly move the glass in one direction in a circular motion. What happens to the water? Observe it. Observe what happens if you whirl a keyring around a finger. So students, let us find answer to all these questions. Can you tell what is the answer to all these questions given below? Let's see. The first one. In which direction did the piece of chalk fall? Yes, the chalk will fall to the right side. Where did the water in the glass show a bulge? Which side it is moving? At the side of the glass. That means it is not in the center. And what is the effect on the movement on the things attached to the keyring? Correct. The things which is attached to the keyring will move round and round. And what happened to the water in the container and the mixer? Correct. The water will swirl around forming a bulge at the sides and a depression in the center. So we understood that in all these activities which we have seen, there is a centrifugal force which is operating. Now let us understand about the centrifugal force. In all this activity which we are seeing right now on the screen, we observe centrifugal force. Now what is centrifugal force? It is in the direction opposite to the earth. That means it is away from the center. You can see in this figure, even when we are sitting in the local fairs in the ferry wheel, we see that our seat is spinning and we are leaning outwards. That is also an effect of centrifugal force. Even when we are playing tug of war, what happens? We are pulling in the opposite direction. Yes, even that is centrifugal force. Now let us try to understand geographically what is centrifugal force and gravitational force. Now due to the rotation of the earth, it gets a power or a force. And that power or force work away from the center. That is called as centrifugal force. Now whenever you are throwing an object which is away from the earth, that is in the space, it is only working because of the centrifugal force. But the gravitational force is much greater than the centrifugal force. And therefore everything on the earth remains stable. It is where it is exist. It does not move or fall apart. Due to the centrifugal force, any object on the earth would be thrown into the space. Do you know how rocket work? Yes, it works on this force, that is centrifugal force. Then you might be thinking that why are we on the earth so firmly stable? The reason behind is that there is at the same time gravitational force acting on the earth surface. Now what is the work of gravitational force? It is working towards the center. Now one force, that is gravitational force, is working towards the center, whereas the centrifugal force is working against the center. It is away from the center. So what happens? Who will win? Correct, the one which is greater. Students, now carefully observe the diagram. Here, M is the center. G is gravitational force. C is centrifugal force. Now, what is the work of the gravitational force? Yes, there is a pull towards the earth. That is the center. Whereas centrifugal force is acting against the gravitational force. It is away from the center. M is the center. G is the gravitational force. C is the centrifugal force. Gravitational force towards the center. Centrifugal force away from the center. That means both are acting in opposite direction. Now, if both are acting simultaneously on the earth surface, then what will happen? Yes, the one which is stronger will win. As we have seen in tug of war, which team will win? The one which is stronger. So here also, the one which is stronger, the force which is stronger will win. Therefore, gravitational force is much greater than the centrifugal force. And that is the reason that the gravitational force act on the surface of the earth many, many times greater than the centrifugal force. Therefore, all the things on the earth surface do not fall apart. They stay stable and firmly on the earth surface. Now let us understand the factors which are responsible for the occurrence of tides. The first and the most important is the gravitational pull. And this pull is not only by the moon, the sun, but also the earth. That means all the three celestial bodies are acting, and due to the gravitational pull of all these three bodies, the tide occurs. The second important thing is revolution of the Earth around the Sun and indirect revolution of the Moon around the Sun. This we have studied in the second chapter. We have seen that when the Earth is revolving around the Sun and when the Moon is rotating and revolving around the Earth, it is indirectly revolving around the Sun. And the last one is the centrifugal force generated due to the rotation of the Earth. The Moon is closer to the Earth than the Sun. Hence, its gravitational force becomes more effective than that of the Sun. Now, students, you know very well that Moon is closer to the Earth than the Sun. Why? Because Sun is very, very far away, whereas Moon is a satellite of the Earth. So, Moon is closer to the Earth as compared to the Sun. So, whose gravitational force will be more effective? Yes, the gravitational force of the Moon will be more effective than the gravitational force of the Sun. You can see in the figure, GM means gravitational force of Moon and GS means gravitational force of the Sun. Students, do you know why the opposite side experience the same type of tide? Yes, it is because of centrifugal force. If one point is experiencing low tide, then exactly opposite point will also experience low tide. Same for the high tide as well. If one point is experiencing high tide, then exactly opposite point will also experience high tide. The reason is the centrifugal force. Now let us try to understand the high tide and the low tide and their location with respect to the Earth. When there is high tide at 0 degree meridian, then at 180 degree meridian also experience high tide. The meridians that are at right angle to those having high tide will experience low tide at the same time. So students, if it is high tide at 0 degree and 180 degree meridian, then at which meridian will low tide occur? Come on, tell me. Yes. The low tide will occur at 90 degree east meridian and 90 degree west meridian. Let's do a short recap quickly. Tides are periodic rise and fall of sea level at a particular place. So rise in the level, high tide. Fall in the level, low tide. Tides are primarily caused due to the gravitational force of the Moon. Now let's see how. See here, the stronger the gravitational pull of the Moon, then yes, it will face high tide. Why? Because that particular region will bulge out, causing high tide. See the gravitational pull of the Moon? Yes. Now on the opposite side as well, as we have seen in the chapter, it will also experience high tide. What about the other two opposite point? Yes, it will experience low tide. So students, in this chapter, we studied what is tide and what are the factors responsible for tide. That's all for today. Thank you.